I tell you, that's a big weight off of anyone's shoulder to know that that check is coming every month.
And so I see the pension board as not just taking care of now, not just taking care of the old folk, but also bringing new people in and giving them the training that they need so they can be successful in that stewardship of the whole church.
We had the privilege of calling over, calling on over 100 clergy, lay, and a missionary. And I tell you, that was just a wonderful opportunity to hear the stories and the gratitude that was expressed about their pension. Whenever we would ask if there was a problem, anything we needed to report, the answers were always very positive. We're just kind of gung-ho on this whole idea of going into generosity of giving back.
United Church of Christ of my past is going to be there to minister to my children, my grandchildren, my great-grandchildren, and part of my legacy is how I can help to urge that along.
We began to think about what would happen after our death, and what assets do we have, and we thought about the condo as a, you know, as a real estate. Because that was one of the things that had been talked about.
And so Charlene and I, we did a good job of selling that to the kids, and they appreciate the fact that they don't have to support us now. It's a pension board's taking care of that.
And so, of course, we had to do a codicil,
Codicil.
codicil to our wills to include the proceeds after both of our deaths. To go to the pension boards. And our children, we discussed that with them, our decision. And it's lucky that the
Unanimous.
unanimous, yeah.
At this end of retirement, I am very, very grateful for the kinds of stewardship that went into the years that I was in the pulpit. I altogether was in the pulpit for over 50 years. And so I have a great respect for that and appreciate the fact that the pension has handled the money so well. They were smart when I was stupid. She's gonna say he's still stupid. That's what she was.
Generations of Service is a $20 million campaign to ensure the sustainability of UCBMA assistance and leadership programs. The Adams have made a planned gift of their condominium to support this effort. Please join them in supporting those who serve, this time, next time, every time.